Alright, welcome back to Let's Play Victoria 2, and we are going to declare war on Belgium. So, I don't want to call my allies right away. Because I want to see who will actually join. Will you join? Likely. We'll go for that. And I will try to call... What about the Ottomans? It's a maybe. They're not that important. We'll try calling them too. That's two great powers. If one of them accepts, then if Spain joins, we'll have a great war. Awesome. Okay, so we have a great war here. This... Unlikely. So, okay, that's fine. The UK can stay out of it. As long as I still have my alliance with them, if anybody declares war on me, they are obligated to join. So, now we are at war with the Netherlands, we are at war with Spain, and we are at war with Belgium and Portugal. Most importantly, Belgium. So... actually, no. How do I want to do this? Let's go here, here, here. And like I kind of explained or hinted at, I'm a little bit rusty on how the mechanics for Great Wars work. I think they've been changed a little bit. Now you stay here. France might get frisky. You can stay there. And I guess we'll send him over here for reinforcements. So the USA is unlikely to actually help us do anything. The Ottomans might actually come help, and they have a lot of dudes. I moved dudes over here to invade Spain's lands here, so we'll go ahead and do that. I can also invade Belgium. Let's go ahead and invade Belgium this way, too. Anywhere else that I can get to... Spain's stuff. I can get there, but not very easily. I'd have to bring down some dudes. Portugal. Hey, yeah, there's stuff down here for Portugal. Okay. The Ottomans might deal with that for me. I don't particularly care about taking any of Portugal's colonies, but that's the kind of thing you do in a great war. Might give those to the Ottomans or something. If they choose to want it. We do have a lot of extra dudes that we can do some stuff with, so. Let's go ahead and come down here. And get our transports. And we might as well... go down and occupy some of Africa. This is going to be a very long war. I might as well micromanage it. As much as I feel I need to. No. Well. Now, if anybody's stupid enough to actually try to pull a fast one and land on me, that would be great. Because that would possibly be the worst thing that they could possibly do. I don't care. More Belgium's dudes. Since they have bad morale, let's just go ahead and go in on them. You just crush them. Okay, what does it look like over here? Sure. Okay. Let's go ahead and just leave these guys here. And did you guys get here? Yeah, the railroads really help out. Okay, I don't really care what the split is. Let's go down here, I guess. Should I call any of my other allies? Maybe. Very likely. Let's call in our two strong bros here. And maybe Sweden. Those guys are strong. I think some of the other guys have, like, algorithms that make them not want to attack people, and thus they choose not to help in wars. These guys have never failed me. Okay. Let's deal with this whole war thing real quick. Okay, well, won the Battle of Brussels. Okay. Don't care. So we are done with army techs. Got some stupid navy techs. Culture. Let's get this. Yes. So it actually does have an impact on things. We've got our sweet-ass German guy looking... sweet-ass looking German guys here. Ooh, we can build airplanes now. Sweet. Okay, so that France has got... they've got military access through France. That sucks. Okay. You can stay there. Let's see. I didn't get my guys here yet. They're right there. I'm not interested in your stupid things. Okay. Looked like that didn't get... yeah, I didn't get any, interest. What? I don't know whether that's a good idea. France. I want to keep things down as much as I can here. Let's go ahead and leave infantry here. And then... actually, no. Let's just send the guys from Kiel here. Okay. Spain, Portugal. The USA is blockading... is the USA landing troops? This is a terrible idea. I don't know what you're doing. You should be occupying these islands over here. USA stupid and never got the cores, though. You know, I don't understand why you would ever not do that. Hello. I'm not sure if you've heard, but we have these things. They're called battleships. I know you've got those sailing ships and they look all nice, but, yeah, battleships. Enter. Okay. Go down here. There we go. It's kind of what I was waiting for. So you go here, you here, you here. That should be most of Belgium. Wait, no, you. Alright, so we've got Spain occupied. Belgium occupied here. Portugal. So here. Now these are the Ottomans colors, yeah, so. It's okay. This is the Netherlands, so I can invade here, or I can just let the Ottomans deal with that. Let's go over and occupy. I kind of like that the Ottomans joined the war. It's very helpful. Should probably go help out down there. Sicily's getting its navy kicked in. I keep not really registering that these guys are Belgium in my head. Because they look the same. So Dinia Piedmont got one of these things up here. Whatever. Now, I'm wondering, it used to be that you could do some crazy stuff when you entered into a great war. Ah, this siege just ended. So I guess we'll see. Right now I just have the CB to take this here, but it's like half of their country, so I'm wondering how much that's actually going to matter, size-wise, as far as what I can actually take from things. Okay, what are you doing over here, USA? The USA actually occupied a little bit, but they're not doing too well. Alright, Great War Capitulation. Okay. So, what does it cost, for example, to add another war or Gulf of Belgium? So I can't really do anything else. What about if I wanted to take something from Spain? Like a, what is that called? This here. Taza. Or. There's not really any other attractive targets. We'll think about that later. Could I add a war goal against the Netherlands? It's a 58 war score to demand in a peace deal, so I can't do that. Actually, maybe I can. It's only three infamy. I think that's the deal, yeah. The deal is it costs a lot less during great wars. Okay. We want to do that too. Okay, so we've got control of pretty much the entire Belgian country. Sure, why you did that. Rubber found somewhere, whatever. The Ottomans. You guys are dumb. Oh, looks like Morocco had already sieged that. Let's go back to paying attention down here. Oh, hi, Portugal. The Ottomans did come. Okay, good. Good. No, I want to get a peace offer from the Netherlands first. What else do I have to do for the Netherlands? The Netherlands owns a lot of stuff. Where's the easiest Dutch colony to take? Dutch East Asia. Sardinia, Piedmont, you're hilarious. Just hilarious. Well, I still don't have very much in the way of infamy leeway, so. Because I got caught so quickly. Oh, these are the Dutch. Okay. apparently the Ottomans don't think they need to help me here. That might in fact be true. No, Belgium. We have things to do. We're not taking any attrition, so that's okay. Wait a minute. Okay, maybe I did waste some infamy there. We'll just have to wait. I normally don't do that because of other reasons, not because... Oh god, look at all the... No! Screw you, guys who aren't guys I want to talk to. Oh good, we did win that battle. No. But you're gonna give me part of the Netherlands. So I guess things are a little less crazy than I thought they were. Cut the Netherlands down to size. Just added a bunch of war goals for no reason, eh? We'll take this off the menu. I just don't want to do this. I think that's the problem. I can't get military access through France, because France completely hates me. But I'm not gonna get embroiled in a war over here, that would be suicide. Not suicide, but it would be dumb as hell. So, we'll just let Spain sit. Dutch reactionaries. What? Colonial crisis. I argue that this present resurgence of native unrest in the colony is due only to the continued, repeated, and wanton mismanagement that our own officials have imposed on the locals. If the purposes of our presence in our far-flung colonies is to uplift and educate, our failure is all the worse when we accomplish the exact opposite. Native militancy is rising in one of our colonies, and reports are reaching Berlin that the reason for this surge in violence is several incidents of colonial mismanagement. Seek to redress the problem by finding scapegoats in the colonial office, but happy bureaucrats might be more important than happy natives in some godforsaken colony. That's right. Okay, I think this might be one of those instances that we have to basically get 100% war score with the Dutch. Which is not necessarily beyond the realms of reason. Let's go ahead and send an army over to the colonies over here. The Ottomans, you deal with this, I will go deal with the Dutch. Can we actually get Portugal out of the war? No. See, we can't even ask for the other war goal from the Netherlands, so clearly I have to do something else. Hmm? What? Oh, Belgium! Well, now we can crush their army. add Abu Dhabi to my... Well, I can increase their opinion of me. Okay. And there we go. Get crushed. Troubles. Okay, rebels. Protectionism. Curse of the Pharaohs of the Netherlands. Okay, cursed. Netherlands. Okay. Rubber. Okay. We can siege this down, then we'll have it. So what do we got for war score against the Dutch? 69%. I don't want these. So the Dutch are, or the Belgians are willing to give in because we've got 100% war score for them. And that's how it works. I'm curious, how much would it be for that colony? Three. I would be under my limit, but I'd rather keep that for later. Or take another state from somebody. Spain or... something. Or take part of Portuguese Africa. It's like, Sardinia, or two Sicilies, decided to show up. That's cool. Okay. It's... actually, that's fine, because that's part of Wallonia. We want to keep occupying Wallonia, because that's... we're going to own that. Go back to Kiel, I guess. Looks like the USA hasn't had a good time there. Brasso. Oh. Whatever. Get fucked, the Dutch. What? He just got an event for a province he doesn't even control. You should stop having cholera, man. Like, seriously, that's bad.